Hey guys, it is Josh, and I'm back with another video. Now, I haven't made a video in a while, solely because the Saab hasn't had any progress in a while. You guys saw I bought a BMW, and I ended up selling the BMW because it had typical E39 electrical issues. Probably needed a new ECU, so I decided to get rid of it because I couldn't stand it anymore. But a lot has changed on the Saab, and that's what today's video is about. So I'm gonna take you and I'm gonna show you what's changed in the Saab. So we're going to the garage right now. Let's go. Long I made it out of here. I don't belong. I see my past everywhere. I just want Timmy's. PTSD. I got a war zone inside of my head. I made it on my own. They said I'd be in jail or dead. I seen my brothers fall over and over again. Don't stand too close to me. Seeing pains like Chief Keef. Always yelling names, that's DC's. I go off my mind and my instinct. Shooting at the same time, we was in sync. So here's my engine. This is it. This is what I've been working on for a while. And this is actually the motor that was in the Saab and is no longer in the Saab. Here are some videos and clips of me taking it out, kind of. So I'll put those in now. And then I'll show you here. Fucking turn this thing over with one hand. We'll see. It's pretty fucking light, but yeah. Okay. We're gonna put you down. Ew. Anyways, so here we go. I'll basically give you the rundown of what I've done on this thing so far. I'm gonna wipe my hand off on something. Yuck. So far, this is no longer the stock bore. Stock bore is 90 millimeters. This is bored out 30 thou over, so it's 91 millimeters. And these are Wossner 91 millimeter forged pistons, fully forged, coated, and everything. Honestly, super good pistons. I'll show you the box. It's over here. Here, this is the box. This is your pistons. That's your bore. Rings, bore, axle, center hole, everything like that. All that came in there nicely, so thank you for Brew City Boost for those, because that's gonna definitely excel this build a lot. A little interjection, when you do buy the 91 millimeter Wossners, the rings don't come gapped. You have to gap them yourself. So to gap them, it's 0.54 for 91 millimeter turbo cars. Go on their website, I'll put it in the description. You can look up, there's a formula there. Here are the stock ones, which we don't care about. Obviously, if you guys want to buy them, let me know for like the rods, because they still are B235R rods, the 2.3s right there. If anyone wants to buy them, but the pistons are junk because, yeah, there's your damage. I don't know if I ever showed you guys. So when I blew this Saab up, I definitely fucked up all the pistons. So basically junk, rods are still good. If you want them, they're yours. Here's $200 worth of fluids. So I have my brake fluid. Well, I got Wilbur brake fluid, everything like that. Filters, oil, brake-in oil, all the goodies.
Coronavirus!
Coronavirus! Here's all my other stuff. So this is my release bearing. I just bought this and I was actually gonna put it in yesterday, but I'll explain why I didn't in a second. Release bearing. Here's my new clutch. It's a Satches clutch. So it's a stock Viggen clutch from Satches. Stock Viggen clutch is strong enough for what I'm doing for right now. If I ever wanna go big power, I can change it out. But here's the clutch, here's the plate, and the pressure plate. Yeah, okay, there you go, that's good enough. What else I got? A bunch of gaskets. I got intake manifold, exhaust manifold gaskets, that whole thing. I got timing chain kit, new tensioner. Tensioner is actually like super, super satisfying to look at because it's super clean. So that's nice. New tensioner. Here's the head. This is the head that was fucked and is no longer fucked. It's on a pad because we have this water issue where water's coming in from the back of the garage. But here is the head. I fully rebuilt it. I'm not gonna turn it over because like there's water and stuff, but I fully rebuilt the head. It's got a bunch of assembly lube on it right now, so it looks kind of gross. But head's fully rebuilt. I just put, I lapped all the valves, put, Same valves, same intake valves. I got new exhaust valves from a new B235R. So if I seem really excited, it's because I am extremely excited. I've been waiting so long for this. Here's the intake manifold. I painted it black because I think black looks a lot better when this puppy gets other side, but you know, you get the gist. This gets put on there like this. Look nice. So I painted that black. I'm gonna paint my direct ignition blue again because the paint's garbage on it. As for turbo, I'm keeping the stock TD04 15THL for now. I will be upgrading to either a 19T or a GT28 71R. So if you guys have, you know, some expertise or, you know, any sort of help you want to give with that, please leave it in the comments. Let me know what you think I should do, and I'll do it. As for that, yeah, this is what's decking it. I didn't need to deck it. It's a little dirty right now, but I cleaned it up. Like, it's perfectly flat. Just sandpaper and a flat bar. Cleaned it up nicely. So this is the block. This is what you're going to be seeing on this channel. The majority of the time, it's just going to be this block. Building it, stuff like that. It's almost done. Actually, if we go inside, I'll show you. I cleaned it up a little bit. Still needs a little more cleaning. I have a new mount coming in. It'll be here tomorrow, actually. It's a new trans mount because this one, yeah, kind of got fucked. So I have a race trans mount from Taliaferro coming in. And here's the release bearing that I had off. But if you can look here, that decided to strip right there. So we're gonna have to figure that out because that might be an issue, but we'll figure that out later. And if you guys have never seen a valve for like a cat motor, there you go. It's fucking huge. All right, so now that I'm done rambling on, this is the other part I got. Always go with ARP. If you're rebuilding a motor, it's like super, super good. This sticker's gonna go on the Saab soon. But I did get ARP head studs, ghost studs. They're better than bolts in my opinion. They hold on a lot stronger. So I got those, which is cool. And now for the other thing. So the Saab is actually at a different garage right now. This is just where I'm building the motor. I gotta fix this. So when we're taking this off, yeah, we'll just leave it as that. I have to fix that. Obviously can't use heat with that because it'll weaken the metal. So I might try to bend it back without heat or see if I can find a new one somewhere. I have new tie rod ends, brand new ones. They're at the Saab right now, but have to figure this out. So that's what we'll do next. All right, now for as far as this video goes, this is the end of this section of it. I was going to post it as its own separate video, but I have decided I'm gonna stop the video currently right now. It is March 30th, and we will resume when my head gasket gets in. I'm thinking it'll be here sometime within next week, or this week, sorry. So we'll see if it comes in. As soon as that comes in, I'll see you, and for you guys, it'll be like 10 seconds. All right, so today is the day after this video just went up, and it is the 31st. And I'm using a gyro, and it's super cool. Gasket's still not here, but I did get a new part in, and I wanted to show you guys it. It's from Genuine Saab. Super excited, I already had it open, but this thing is freaking awesome. So I got a new one, but I didn't just get like the typical new one, because I was like, well, that's just pointless. If it breaks, upgrade it, right? It's freaking awesome. Now, it's got like a whole billet front plate, says Taliaferro. It's pretty cool, and I'm really excited about it, because this will eliminate all my shifting issues I was having before. Because the trans mount was blowing, every time I would, you know, have it in first and I'd floor it, the whole shift knob would do this. A short throw in, I'm putting this in, it'll be a lot better. Anyway, I will see you guys all when the gasket gets in. All right, I'm back, and the gasket is in. So that's why you're seeing this. Here's the head gasket. It came in. It's an L-ring standard one. I don't need anything more than that because I'm running ARP studs. The studs are in. We have to do the timing. So I got all my timing here. I'm gonna put the timing on, balance chains, balance shafts, all that stuff. Timing cover, head gasket, put the head on, put the cam gears on, time it, make sure it's in time, and go from there. What it really mean? I can't sleep because it's a war zone in my head. My killer's good, they know I'm hands on with the bread. $1 million. All right, so we're back. Little updates. All the timing's on, balance chain's on. If you guys have any questions, if you guys are doing this yourself on how to get this done, ask me. I couldn't record and do it at the same time. I had stuff to look up, and it was kind of a pain in the ass. Otherwise, that's done. Timing's all done, and now we're just putting the head on with the head studs. And I left one here. We're going to show you how to do it. So when you're first putting the stud on, you're going to take the stud, you'll put it into the, before you put the head on, you put the stud in, you'll tighten it with an Allen, get it, you know, snug. Once you get it snug, get them all snug, do everything you have to do, put the head gasket on, Then you set the head down. Before you do that, before you set the head down, put molly on all like the threads on the top. This liquid molly here, this stuff they have, this friction molly, assembly lube. Use that first, and then you put the head on, and then what we did is we took a little rod, put some molly on the, did our rod just fall?
It just fell.
And then what we did is we put some molly on the nut, used that rod, slid the nut down the rod, and then took an extension with a 14 mil, put it on after, so he'll show you.
Keep that pin. Stay. And attack.
Final torque's 88, but obviously you do like three stages before, so we'll probably do 40, 60, 88, and then go from there. All right, little update for you guys. So the motor's almost all ready to go. Brandon, say hi. So at the time, these motors, they're actually not too difficult, a little finicky. You're gonna have a mark right there. I'll zoom in here. There's two marks, you see them there. That's on both cams. And on the crank cover, you're gonna have this mark, and then on the actual crankshaft pulley, you're gonna have that mark right there. Now, all you want is all those to line up at the end of the day, and you're good. Other than that, I'm gonna keep working on this. We should be done most of this by the end of the day. We're gonna put the timing cover on, oil pan, get the clutch assembly and all that on. I'll show you guys how to align a clutch properly, and then we'll go from there. All right, it is like 10:30 at night. We are so tired, but we're still working because we had an issue with the head, and it was being stupid, and I don't want to talk about it. But it's on, it's good. The motor's actually looking really good. Like, it looks really pretty, actually, and I'm happy with how it's turned out. So I was gonna paint this, but then I decided not to because it's gonna get rusty anyway, and I didn't have the energy to do that right now. So basically all that's left is this oil pan and that stuff, and we're tired.
I'm a big dog, baby, I'm a buck back. Buck, got a badass bitch with her own racks. They don't like it, they don't like it, tell them fuck that. Fuck that. Whoa, cut strong, get your contact.
Bitches wanna talk to me, can't contact. Hit my nigga for the plug, key to contact. And we only do big contracts. Whoa, cut strong, get your contact. Knew she was the one soon that she opened her mouth. Heard you from the west, but built like you from the south. Your nigga always tripping, don't let you leave the house. Reminding me of my Impala when she making it bounce. You never smoke, you think of me, you think of an ounce. You heard about me, now you wanna see what it's about. I be smoking on some gas, yeah, get the cash, yeah. Hit it, got you coming fast, yeah.
Alright, so it's midnight now, but we are finally done. And she looks fucking awesome. I'm so excited. Thank you to this kid. Okay. It is bedtime. Tomorrow we'll come back and we'll do the clutch and everything, but it is bedtime. I'm tired. Pop cover's on, everything's on. This stuff is just temporary paint. I just threw it on because of coronavirus. Nothing's open, so I can't get anything powder coated. But this will eventually be different color, so will this. But that's just temporary for now. It's just some rattle cam paint. But yeah, I'm extremely happy with that. Anyway, that is probably it for this video. You guys will see the next video come up of us installing it and starting it. Hoping that'll come up next week. I want to have it running on Monday, so we'll see how that goes. This is going up actually tomorrow morning, so not tonight. And then you'll see it because I'm too tired to fucking edit it and everything tonight. But she's done. She's ready to go. And fingers crossed. But anyway, I'll see you guys next video. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed, go ahead and subscribe, like, do whatever you fucking don't throw it at me. And I'll see you guys later. And peace. Say bye. Contact. Hit my nigga for the plug, key to contact. And we only do big contracts. Whoa, cush strong, catch a contact.